Leaving football, it's nearly 2 years, isn't it, since you...
Yeah, it is 2 years.
It is 2 years. So, obviously you missed the game, but it must be kind of a relief as well to just not have that regime and that discipline.
I wouldn't say it's a relief because I've, you know, I was very lucky to have a career that lasted for 22 years, you know, and I played for some of the best clubs in the world. I played with some of the best players and under the best managers in the world. So I had a very long career, but, you know, I wouldn't say it's a relief. It just, I knew it was the right time to finish.
No days have you... Sorry,
no, no,
I'm
go.
A sports
fan. No, please go, go, no. Go,
relax,
go.
But no days, like in the last 2 years, like after the first 6 months, you went, maybe I'll go back late. Any days you woke up and go, oh.
The day after, I literally was like questioning myself whether I'd made the right decision. And then every time, even now, you know, every time that I go to a big sporting event or watch England play, you know, I loved playing for all the clubs that I played with over the years. But the one thing that I miss more than anything is playing for England. It's one of the things that I was most proud of, being given the England armband and being able to captain my country for the amount of time that I did. You know, it's the one thing that I miss out of football that really kind of not every single day, but every time England come around for their games and every time they go into a big competition, it's one thing that I really kind of, it really kind of gets to me.
Yeah.
But if Norwich City came back to you now...
I just want to be clear.
Yeah. Delia's poised.
I'll take it as a maybe. All right.
Hey, but you are still involved in football because, of course, the boys all play.
Yes, they do.
Which must be weird pressure on them. Because they're all very good, I'm sure. Like, one of... isn't Brooklyn, he's now...
Yeah, Brooklyn, Romeo and Cruz, they're all at the Arsenal Academy.
Yeah.
And they...
Norwich got a bigger.
But didn't you... this is mean. Didn't you ref one of the matches?
Yeah, for Romeo. Romeo was playing in a game, and Romeo is... he's the most emotional out of all of the kids, actually. Yeah. So... you know, I could say no to him and his bottom lip goes. So, you know, he was playing this game and the referee hadn't turned up. So all the parents were looking at me as if to say... Yeah, really?
You're David Beckham.
So I went onto the pitch and I started refereeing the game. It was going great. They were winning 4-0. And then one of the opposition players went through towards our goal. I shouldn't say that goal. I was and Romeo went to make a tackle, and he missed the ball and took the player down. So it was an obvious penalty, and I'm thinking, oh no, I really don't want to make this decision. But then I look at our parents, and they're like, and then I look at the other parents, and they're like, I knew I had to give the penalty. So I give the penalty, and Romeo's looking at me, and I can see his like, eyes are welling up. I can see his bottom lips going. And the kid... So the kid stepped up, took the penalty. I shouldn't say thankfully, but he missed it. and as our team were breaking, as Romeo's team was breaking, he ran past me. He said, "I can't believe you did that, Daddy."
The Graham Norton Show, all new Saturday at 10:50, only on BBC America. For copious further examples of humour with an OU, subscribe now to the BBC America channel on YouTube. You'll thank yourself.